I learned from the Vice Chancellor of Nepal Open University, Professor Lekhnath Sharma. So when I heard about this workshop, I thought that this is a wonderful opportunity for our Tribhuvan University faculty to join this workshop so that they can learn how the online education works and the experience around the globe that you bring with your rich experience. So for the audience, Professor Ramesh Sharma is a very accomplished person in this area. He's been the director, executive director of several institutes in the past. And this is the space he has been working, information and communication technology in education. This is the space that he's been working for a long time. He looks very young, but he has a very long and diverse experience. So without any further ado, I would like to again welcome you with our big hearts and warm welcomes to the Nepalese community, and then I would like you to continue your workshop. And I think before that, Professor Sharma from Open University might have a few words.
Yes. Thank you. Professor Sharma, your microphone is on. Please, you can speak now.
Lekhnath sir.
Hello.
Lekhnath sir.
We can hear you perhaps.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
We can hear you. Please speak few words.
My system is not working.
It is working. We can listen. Please share a few words in the opening. Yes, we can hear you now clearly. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much. And first of all, I would like to welcome you all in this very grand session of this webinar. And first of all, I would like to pay my great respect to Professor Sharma, who managed time and then arrange such a meeting. And we are many people here, I think we are joining. And I don't know why my computer is not working, and I became in a very trouble right now. But I don't see my mic is working here, but my sound is going to you. So thank you very much for arranging all these things. And thank you, Ganga sir, for coordinating all university staffs, and then in next session also, in another time also, we'll get more contribution from Professor Sharma. So I would like to request Professor Sharma to continue your presentation and your whatever you would like to do regarding this, what online education is, how online education is possible using learning management system and other things, and how Moodle can be used for making everything, assignment as well as record of the professors who are taking classes or not, and the student attendance and everything. So thank you very much for this arrangement. I'm very grateful to you, Professor Sharma. Thank you very much. I'll be joining with you.
Sure. Thank you. And again, Professor Ramesh Sharma, may I request all the participants to mute their microphone while Professor Sharma is speaking. And if he gives you space to ask questions, then only unmute your microphone. He will call your name, or he will allow us to speak, then you can speak. Otherwise, mute your microphone so that everybody can hear Professor Sharma clearly and crystally. Over to you, Professor Sharma.
Thank you, Professor Sharma and Professor Gautam. I note that there are some colleagues whose screen name is showing as Lenovo, then NOU. So maybe you can rename yourself so that when this chat is saved later on, we can make out that in reality who was in attendance at this time. So this way, let me now start sharing my screen. And I hope now you can see my web browser. Just if you can type yes in the chat box, then I will find that it is okay. Okay, good. So thank you very much. So So my purpose today here is to proceed like this. And as Vishay Saab and Professor Gautam, he has very rightly told you that the significance of online education, and particularly not only due to this pandemic time, but even otherwise also, it is the need now that how we need to proceed it. And particularly like the Himalayan kingdom, you know, the far-flung areas, it is not easy to for the students to travel to the college or university or school, and then teachers to go there. So this electronic medium is a very big opportunity for us to use it in a big way. Now, when we go online, we need to prepare our lessons, we need to prepare our presentation, we need to do something which we will be putting online. And that brings a very serious issue of how we are using the medium, because then it will be seen by everyone. And please remember that copyright is a very serious issue. Normally what we do, we have to prepare any lesson, any content, e-content, then we go to the Google, search for something. Okay, I want to prepare, for example, something on a biology lesson. I want some photograph of leaf. I go there and, this leaf, this image is very good. Let me take it. And I simply copy it, download it, and paste it in my presentation. So that is not the right way. And particularly if unconsciously, if we are taking the copyright protected material of someone, please remember that the institution's reputation is at stake. So we need to be very careful that the personal reputation of the individual, of the faculty, of the teacher, as well as bigger than that, the reputation of the institution is very, very important. We should not do anything due to which our institution, it should come into the bad light. And that's why first I want to show you the certain websites from where we can use their material legally, means it is completely allowed. But before that, let me tell you a little bit about Creative Commons licenses. So say, these are the six kind of Creative Commons licenses. First of all, why they are needed? The problem arises that we have lot of all the textbooks, other journals, etc., which are copyright protected materials. And we as a teacher, we need to access them. But how do we access them? We need to either purchase the textbook or subscribe to the journal or something that goes there. But nowadays, the textbooks are going expensive. The libraries, they don't have that much of the budget. And particularly if the institution doesn't have big financial resources, it becomes a challenge to purchase the books or to subscribe to the journals. But as a teacher, we need the access. We need to access the material. So what should be done? And particularly if we are careful that we should not be violating the copyright license of some intellectual property of some organization or a person. In that case, then in the year 2001, Larry Lessig established the short of an NGO, non-profit organization. It is called as Creative Commons. And the Creative Commons, they suggested these six kind of licenses. The situation here is that the UNESCO in the year 2001 accepted the term open educational resources. It means these are those kind of resources which we can use openly. Openly means in terms of its access. So that makes it very easy. And here it just says that a copyright protected material, we need the permission of the publisher. I hope you understand it very well, that if you are referring to the textbook of someone, you need to have the permission to use that material. But here, the permission is already granted to you. So it means you can, if you find any resource on which any of these kind of licenses are available, At least the first thing is that you don't need to ask the owner or the publisher or the author of that work. That has already been granted. So we are saved in that way, that already the people, they are asking you, say, for example, let me show it to you. How does it look like? Say, this is my presentation, and here I have put this license. So it means anybody can use this presentation, and then they can download it. My another presentation, which I made, how to make, see, there is another license. So in that way, you give the license to your product, and then the people will know that yes, you can make use of that. You can download it, you can reuse it, and depending on the license, you can even modify that depending on. So very briefly, I will just first, the first one is CC BY. It means we need to just attribute, we need to tell that, okay, this matter, this content was created by this person, and that's all. After that, you are free to revise, redistribute, remix. Even you can make a commercial use of that. Suppose I wrote a essay and you liked it very much and you want to print it and sell it in the market, it's okay for you. CC BY. The second is CC BY share alike. SA stands for share alike. It means the new product which you create will have the same license. Otherwise, you can revise it, you can remix it, you can modify it, and so many things. The next one is CC BY NC. NC here stands for non-commercial. So anything on which there is an NC license, we cannot make a commercial use of that. We cannot sell that, but we can make a derivative out of that. We can revise that material. And then there is ND. ND stands for no derivative. No derivative means we cannot revise. I cannot change the material. Means, suppose if you find an you are creating a lesson on, say, photosynthesis, in which the plants, they have green pigment called as chlorophyll. Sunlight falls on chlorophyll, and then through chlorophyll, that is converted into carbohydrates, and the plants give us oxygen. This is the thing, one. And you want to use it in your work, but you think that the examples are given of Brazil, but we want to have the examples which are suitable for Nepal. So I need to change something. So if there is ND in that work, you won't be able to modify that work. So you need to find other work in which there is no ND sign into it. And that way you can use it. So this is just a brief there. I can have another session if you want to learn more about the open educational resources. And I am very happy that Professor Lekhnath Sharma, Vice Chancellor of Nepal Open University, they are already a member of Open Educational Resources University. It means that the products, the courses, are the training programs created by OERU, you can now freely use them. If they have created a course, and if you think that this course will be good for the students of Nepal, you can just take down all the material and start offering that course in your institution. They won't ask for any money or any hindrance into it. You just use all that material and start that course at your institution, and you can award the degrees. So that is the beauty. You don't need to spend 6 months, 1 hour in creating a course for you. Already, if the course is created by someone else, and if it is shared with you, you just go ahead and use that. So that is the power. Now, when we create the one of the functions for you, now in this time is, let me divide it into this way. First of all, you need to create e-content. सबसे पहले आपके पास मटेरियल होना चाहिए, तभी आप उसको आगे पढ़ा पाएंगे. सो यू नीड टू हैव द ई कंटेंट विद यू. एंड टू हाउ टू क्रिएट ई कंटेंट, वेयर यू नीड टू सी द रिसोर्सेज फ्रॉम दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. डोंट यूज कॉपीराइट प्रोटेक्टेड मटेरियल इन योर वर्क इफ यू हैव नॉट ऑब्टेंड इट थ्रू प्रॉपर मीन्स. मीन्स इफ यू हैव परचेज द बुक, इवन देन यू आर यूजिंग इट, not for further use. You have purchased that book for your reading pleasure only, like that. So creation of e-content. The second is to teach that. For teaching that, you need two things. One, a certain sort of a platform, which we call it learning management system, on which you will be putting your content material. So the learning management system, for example, NOU is using Moodle, which is one of the top rated, the best open source learning management system. And the second is an online medium through which you can teach your students. Like now, we are online face to face with each other, and we are talking now. You can ask questions, I can reply to those questions, you can type the questions, I can type my, so it is in real time, the real time communication. The next thing is assessment purpose, evaluation of students. Formative assessment and summative assessment. Formative assessment is during the tenure of the duration of the course, that how the student is learning, we need to find that. And summative assessment is done at the end of the semester, end of the year, wherever you think that now the course has been completed and we need to have the examination of the students. So online examination, and Moodle serves the purpose of everything. You can configure your Moodle in such a way that it will allow you what you were doing in your class as such. You can do it completely through that platform in online medium. So with this, the initial background about it, how we need to create e-content, I wanted to show you this very important information about Creative Commons licenses. Now, I am recording this session, but still you can, if you want, you can keep writing in your notepad there. So first of all, I will show you the places from where we can search copyright free images. And there are certain personal, I mean, websites which I use personally in most of my presentations. And just now I was showing you, say, for example, here is my page. And let me show you my one of my presentation, say this one. I was the keynote speaker in Turkey in this conference just a few months ago. And if you see, if I have used any image from extra source, I have given it citation. See here, you can see it, it is there. This is my own university. Here I have used it, this website, and I have quoted it. Here is the image, I have quoted it. This is our book, my book on e-learning. This is from Television Grab. Here you can see the image and its source. So the main thing is that for your presentations, we need a lot of graphics. And if we just take any graphic, it may be not a good idea to use just any website. So there are certain proper websites which we should use it. So one is Unsplash. You can see, read it here. It is internet source of freely usable images. And you can search from here various things, like very recently, nowadays we are talking of COVID-19. So if you want to search some images related to that for your students to teach them that how to remain safe in COVID. So you can see that in particular way, they are there. So you can think that, oh, okay, this image is good, I can use it. And like that. So you have found, you can find for nature. Yes, I will make available the recording of this session after this. So we have nature, we have wallpaper, texture, pattern, people, business, travel, technology, animals, many things are, you know, it has a very big resource, big database on. So you think that, okay, you want to use this image, you simply click on it and this image will be there. You see here, it is written download for free. And then maybe you can share this image with others because you are allowed to share it. And if you want to see its more information, then you can see about that. It has been downloaded only this month. And so far it has so many million, 2 million views, this image. It was shot by this Canon. These are the certain informations and the dimensions which you can use. And you, when you download it, it will open and they here it will save it in your disk, so you can download this image. And here it gives you the link also that how you can cite this image. Just copy this and paste it in your presentation. It's very simple. So this website is called as Unsplash. You can use it very well, and it has millions of images on various things. You can and if you are kind enough, you would like to share your things with others, you can create your ID and you can submit your photograph from here. So this is one site. Another site is Pixabay. So this is, you can see over around 2 million high quality images shared by talented community. And you can find image means photograph, vector graphics, illustrations, videos. There are many things available on this website. And you can say, okay, the images are divided into two categories, the raster image and vector image. You know, sometimes if you zoom out, you expand an image, it starts getting pixelated. वो उसका क्वालिटी खराब होने लग जाएगा, उसमें डॉट डॉट आने लग जाएंगे. दीज आर कॉल्ड एज द पिक्सल्स. एनी इमेज इज मेड ऑफ पिक्सल. सिमिलरली यू सी योर मोबाइल फोन, यू से दैट इट इज 14 MP मेगा पिक्सल, एंड फॉर योर टेलीविजन इट इज 4K मीन्स 4000K. द मोर डेंस द पिक्सल्स दे आर, द बेटर क्वालिटी ऑफ द इमेज वुड बी. सो द नंबर शुड बी लार्ज for a better quality of image. But if you are making a use of that photograph for online purpose, please remember that use a small resolution. Otherwise you won't be able to upload it on a website, you won't be able to send it by email to your colleagues, to your students, something like that. And if you are using any image for, say, offline purpose, so for example you want to take the photograph of this mountain or any of this photograph, and you want to make a banner of that, then better use a high resolution photograph, because that will come in print, it will look much better. So that is the difference in that. And it is always better to use three formats you should prefer: JPG, PNG, portable network graphics, and TIFF. These formats, they are always better for online there, and use them. Somebody is asking that how you can change on your screen. When you find in the upper corner an icon, there you can click, right click on it, and it will ask you to rename yourself. You can change your name from there, or you can just quit and then log in. And when you log in, then it may ask you to give your name, so that way you can do. So now, say for example, here if we are searching for, say, economics, I want to prepare some lesson in economics, and there are certain images which I think that, okay, for economics, what I want to show, okay, I want to show this image that how the agricultural economics is here. This photograph is very good, I want to use it. So see here the beauty on the right, free download. So it allows you to free download. And here is the license. See the kindness of the people, it is free for commercial use. So if I want to use this photograph, make a banner out of it and go to the market and sell it, perfectly all right, commercial use we can make. And the second thing is that even the person says, who is the author? Here is the person who has created. And if you can see, already this person has contributed 2500 images already on this platform. So here they says that even if you don't want to cite, it's okay. So here no attribution required. So you click on any image, you can search, there is a lot of thing. And about this particular image, here are the dimensions, this is the resolution. This picture was created on 3rd April, very recently. It was uploaded just few days ago, and it has been downloaded already by these many times. So it gives you an idea that how this thing it works. Next site is fotter.com. This is again, you see, there are so many things. 335 million free stock images. So it means it has a wonderful thing, and you can see you can sort them by category. If you want to find such something for education, interiors, technology, people, sports, nature, food, anything, or you can search it by idea also. Means you are not sure, but you know that you want to show something related to home improvement, or it has lot of ideas into it as to give you some help accordingly, then you can make. So let us see, if I want to search something for, say, blockchain technology. So here it will show me the pictures, and okay, I think that this photograph will be good for me. Okay, I will go with this image. It shows me that how I can use my mobile phone for this. So this website has some other characteristics that if you want to use this, see how. First, it shows you that how you can get this image. So from small up to the extra large, its dimension, it will be very big when you download it. So good for banner, the large size. Either you can download it or you can embed it. Embedding means in your website, in your LMS, it is allowed. You can embed it. Embedding means it will just display it there. Giving a URL means you are sending your user to some other option outside your area. But here you are able to embed it. So these two things. And then second, license. So here it is no derivatives. It means you commercial use is okay. You can sell this, but you cannot change this. Now, how do you change it? Here, suppose, for example, if you want that along with this mobile phone in the photo, you want to put a book here. So it means you will be modifying this image. That is not allowed in this particular case. There are other images where you can find it. And then here is the its attribution. If you means it says attribution required, you just copy it and paste it in your thing, and that will be okay in this case. Let us see another example in which we don't have the issue. Say, for example, I want to search some information on lion, and there are so many photographs which I found. Say I like this photograph, I will click on it, and see here the license is changed now, and here says that modifications okay. So I can change this photograph now. Depending on the background, I see this green jungle. What I can do, I can add a photograph of the cub of the lion here to show them that the lion is with the family, or I can add a tree, or I can add some meat piece that the lion is eating something that way. So you can, modifications are allowed on that. So this is this website called as Fotter. Let me show you one more that is called as flickr.com. This Flickr website is purchased by, it is owned by Yahoo now, and it has a very good resource of millions. You can say here, see, home of 10 of billion of photographs, means tens of billions of photographs, such a huge database it has. And you can search many, many things on this website, and all they say that start for free. So for example, if you are preparing some lesson on virus, you just put your term there, virus, and it will show you all the images wherever the virus is there. So you see everything is there. Now we need to think here, click on any license, and from here we can see that what kind of license we want, which image we can use. I want to use an image which I can little bit modify for my purpose also. So here, or all Creative Commons, anything it will show me, and accordingly when I click it, it will show me only the Creative Commons licenses. Now, another speciality of this website here is I can search an image with a particular color also. Say I want to show danger, that virus is a dangerous thing. And then red is the color of danger. I can click here on the red, and now it will show me the images mostly where the red color is dominant. So you can see the red color is dominant in all these photographs. And then I can see that which image is good for me to use. Then I can have the, these are called as the patterns, means I can search something I can use as the background image for my work and like that. So this way we can use it. Normally you all use Google search engine. Google search engine has become very powerful. Sometimes, let me tell you some cases. Long back, I remember that I gave a presentation on examination system, and I had used a photograph there of to show that how bad our examination system is. What the examination system is currently, we have all kind of students in our class, intelligent, average, poor students, but we give them a simple common question paper. 5 questions, attempt all the questions, and then it is the examination is same. So I want to find that photograph again, because I have to, and I don't remember that where, on which website I saw that image from where I took it. I need that photo again. So what I will do, I will go to the website, say Google search, and I will type few words like examination. I know that there was tree in that photograph, and there were some animals in that photograph. Just these 3 words I remember, and I will click on it, and you see it has shown me the photographs. Let me enlarge it so that you can understand that what that image was. And here you can see what it says, that for a fair selection, everybody has to take the same exam. Please climb that tree. This is a satire on our examination system, that monkey can climb the tree, it is okay, but how the elephant will climb, how the fish will climb, how the seal will climb. But the teacher is saying that all the, to the students, take this examination, and those who will do this, they will be declared as pass. So that way it's a thing. So, but I can use the net to search something for me. Let me show you another example. I remember that once I was giving a presentation on the power of internet, and the internet has become very, very powerful, so that it has so many things that it becomes difficult for us to select that which information is good for us. And I remember that there was a slide in which there was a fire hydrant into it. So what I will do here in Google, I will type fire hydrant. It was yellow in color, so I will tell the computer yellow, and then there was a mention of internet on it. Let's just see that if it can show me that image. Here it is, you can see, and you can see that and here if you see, this image is from Flickr. It is showing you Flickr, Twitter, and getting information of the internet is like taking a drink from a fire hydrant. You know how difficult it is if you start drinking water from like tube well or fire hydrant. You will get wet, because so much of the water will come to us. We need only little bit that way. So these are the things here we can use the power of Google. Another important aspect here of the Google search engine is to use its advanced search engine. So here either I type advanced search engine there, or when I'm somewhere, I use the, go to the settings. For example, if I type here leaf, and I want to search some images of the leaf, but not every leaf here, say like this image is from Britannia.com, this image, and Britannia is, it is written here, images may be subject to copyright, because it is Britannia.com, it is the published house from the company there. So the images will be copyright protected, but we don't want anything, we want open source images. So what we will do, The search is still there. I will go to settings. I will go to advanced search. And here is my keyword. Now, those of you who are from science, mathematics, computer science, you may be knowing that there is a word we call it as Boolean. Let me type it here. B-O-L-E-A-N, Boolean. Boolean means and, or, not, these kind of things. So what does it indicate? If I type that Nepal and Rudraksh, and here means both. So it will return me those search engines in which Nepal and Rudraksh, they both word will be there. If I say Nepal or Rudraksh, it will show me the results in which either the Nepal is there or Rudraksh is there, either of the two. If I say Nepal, not Rudraksh, so it will show me the results on Nepal, but it will eliminate those results in which Rudraksh is mentioned. So that way you can define your search. So these are the extra power of internet. But here, after making your thing, you can decide about the size, large size, small size, and you can decide a color, any color, full color, background, transparent, this, or you can select a color, and you can type any region. If you want any leaf of a particular country, it can help you in that. And then here is the last one, the usage right, which you will be using. Free to use, free to share, free to commercially, free to modify, whatever you want. You click on that and use the advanced search. So it will show you here. And here you can see the first image is from Wikimedia. Wikimedia is a free to use it. Wikipedia, Pingming, Pixabay, I showed it to you. All these images you can very well freely, safely use them in your work. Here, no copyright problem for you. See, such a beautiful resource. Means so many photographs available there, and you can use them for, means you can search for anything here. And here you see this is has come labeled for non-commercial reuse with modification. So this particular image which you have selected, you can use, you can modify them, and you can make a use for you, but not for commercial use of them, like that. And that way you can see its type, a time, wherever you want to search, you can use them. Nayan is asking, what about Wikipedia? The Wikipedia is an example of open sharing. So any entry on Wikipedia, say for example, this image is from Wikipedia. You can see here, you can very well use it. Just give the site the source. Say for example, if I go on this page, and here all the examples are there. This is all about these resources. And if you go to the bottom of the page here, you will say that the Wikipedia, these are text is available under Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike licenses. And similarly for the image, if there is any image, you can click on that and the image will be opened. And you can read the here, you can see more details, CC BY SA. It means you can, if you click on it, it will tell you what is the definition of this. It means that you are free to share it and to adapt it. It means you can remix, you can build upon any purpose, even commercially use this. So that is the advantage of Wikipedia. I also use most of my PowerPoints either text, even I take text from there, and images or resources from Wikipedia, because it allows me. I just take care that I cite the source of that page. Particularly if I'm using it, I'll simply copy it from here, or even it allows you, that is the thing of it, that even it suggests you that how to cite. It gives you a ready-made citation about using it. You can simply copy this sentence here, and that will make it the citation of its source, so that you can very easily use it. So this was about the images which you heavily used for your course. Now let's go to video, because video is very important and you may find some good videos which you want to use in your classroom. But any video, and particularly what is the most common source for videos? We search for YouTube. So we go to YouTube, but please remember that any video on YouTube is not allowing you to download it, because it may be with a standard YouTube license. For example, say this video is on yoga. Let us see what kind of license this video has. So this is the video. Below that, here is the category, and there is no mention. There is no mention of license. So if there is no mentions, in the absence of license, please remember that if there is no mention of Creative Commons license, it means it is copyright protected. Without permission, we cannot use it. So what do we do? Now what we will do here, say for example, on the same topic, if I want to search something on yoga, I will put my here, and these are the results displayed. But still, it may or may not be a copyright protected image. So let us see any image, maybe like if we want to see this one, let us open that and see if it is copyright protected or not. Okay, so this is the image and this is the video. Let us play this video. And here is that video. And here is the description, show more. Here. So it means this video is copyright protected. What we should do now? So we will do this. Come here. Okay, let me just stop this video. Here. Okay. So please remember, see this filter button. You need to click this filter button, and here, this is the hidden treasure of YouTube. You can search for when the video was uploaded, if you know that about its time. वो कौन सी टाइप का वीडियो है? वीडियो है या चैनल है या प्लेलिस्ट है या मूवी है या शो है, टेलीविजन शो, जैसे वो छोटा वीडियो है या बड़ा वीडियो है. एंड हेयर इज क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स. यू कैन फाइंड 360 डिग्री 3D वीडियो, लोकेशन बेस्ड वीडियो. इफ यू वांट टू सर्च समथिंग फॉर काठमांडू लोकेटेड, यू कैन हैव ए लोकेशन बेस्ड वीडियो. और मुंबई का कुछ देखना है, ऐसे करके वो सब टाइटल्स मीन्स जो आवाज है, द स्पीकर इज स्पीकिंग, इट इज कमिंग विद द टेक्स्ट ऑन द स्क्रीन, दैट इज सब टाइटल्स. सो हेयर इज क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स, वी विल क्लिक ऑन इट. एंड नाउ ऑल दीज वीडियोज दे विल कम, दे विल बी विद ए open license. For example, you may be knowing about Baba Ramdev. He is a very famous person who is promoting yoga and about pranayam, anulom vilom, those things. So you can click on that video, and here you can show these are the things available and category. Here it says that non-profit and activism. So it means you can use this video for your non-profit, non-commercial activity like that. And you can search for many of this, the same thing you can use it. So this is how you can use YouTube and search only those things which are with, say, I use Photosynthesis. And here is the filter, it comes, I go to Creative Commons. And these are the results which is allowing us. I click on a video, and if I go here in the description, here you can see the license, Creative Commons, reuse allowed. So you are free to use this presentation, video for your own classroom lecture. That way you can use it. There is another resource for you to search for videos is how to download YouTube video. Bharat is asking. Okay, that is a simple thing. We will tell you two things. First, let me show you this teacher tube. This is the teacher tube page. Click on that. And this is a free community for, you can search the lessons for science, mathematics, history, social studies, language arts, and including educational songs. And you can type here, say, okay, the page is coming up. You can type for, say, algebra. And here you can see there are so many things, whatever you want to search for that. So that will come on algebra and the video will appear. Here are the videos, and in fact you can search the audio also. On this topic there is no audio, but the videos are available, and you can click on them and then you can use them. So here, if you click on it, it will show you that video which you can download from their website. That way you can go it. Now another resource is which is very good on science subjects, that is called as MIT Blossoms. This is MIT Blossoms. Here you can say this is math and science video lessons, and if you go to the bottom of the page, you see here it is written blended learning, open source science or mathematics studies, and so many languages are there, English, Chinese, Japanese, Portuguese, and so many languages. You can see here you can click on any topic which you want. And here is the power of exponentials, big or small. And here is these are the instructors, Swati Gupta, John, and Natalie. The beauty of this website is what I like it. See, language. So this particular video is available in English, Malay subtitles, which is spoken in Malaysia, Spanish, Mandarin, which is Chinese, and even Urdu. So many languages this video is available. You can download this video in various formats, and not only this website gives you the transcript either as PDF or MS Word. So if you think there is anything good for you, even you can use the transcript, because transcript is sometimes very good for students who sometimes are not able to hear it clearly, or they don't understand the language of the person speaking, so they can read it from there, and that makes it a good resource. So this is for there. Now let's see if we say again photosynthesis and how to download the video. We go to the video, and you can say in this video you want to use it. So you go to that particular video, and then what you do here, the simple way is, what I do is the simple way is, before Y of YouTube, you just add double S, like super saver or speed saver, double S, and press enter. You can download this SaveNet form also if you want. But here, this video has come. And from here you can decide that you want the MP4 in 360 format, which is little small in size, or 720, which is a high resolution, and you can select it, and then you can click on download, and then see here I can save it, I can open it, and it will be saved in my computer. From there I can use it. Okay, so this is about the videos. Now the videos are created by someone else. Suppose if you are creating your video, if you are creating your presentation, and you want some music in the background with that video, so from where you can start. And remember, for music If you have some party, some marriage, some birthday celebration, we just play a song there. Within our house, it is okay, but not for main functions, like if it is a big marriage hall and there we are playing, because all the music is released by the particular industry with those phonic there, the act there, and it prohibits us from unauthorized display or playing that music. So there are certain websites from where we can get them. One is SoundCloud. You can use it from there. So this is one, SoundCloud. You can search, and you can search their database. You can explore what are the trending playlists, and then it can show you the stream, the library, and if you like anything, then it has, means it is available even as a mobile app also, which you can use, and if you think that there is something good for you, you can use them for your work. Another website is called as Free Sound. Here you can see that it is a collaborative database of Creative Commons licensed sounds for music and sound lovers. So let us see this website, Free Sound. Here the Free Sound, you can search sounds and see here it is written. It is a big database. You can browse, you can download, you can share the sound from there. You can click on it and you can see Strong Wind. If you think that it is okay for you, you can click and it will play. And here you can see this is licensed under attribution license. This is the format, this is the duration, this is the size, and it is a stereo sound like that. So that way you can check and use this a website. Another one is Jamendo Music. So here is the Jamendo site. You can see it is free streaming, free use. It allows you. So here you can see the free download of various kinds, which you think good for you, you can use it. You can explore it later. Okay. So this was all about multimedia. Now what about the text? From where you can find a good text? So one of the resource is, say, like Athabasca University Press. This is Canada's first open access press. And you can see that all the books and journals are in open access. And I would suggest Professor Sharma also to download some books, and Professor Gautam, because you are going for online. Let me show you, there are some wonderful books on online learning, online teaching, and you can use them. Say like Online Distance Education, Emerging Technologies in Distance Education. Okay, let us see this book. And then Issues in Distance Education. Theory, this book I wanted to recommend you very highly. These theories. Those of you from distance education, you may be knowing Dr. Terry Anderson. He's a wonderful person. And this book of his has been translated into more than 60 languages around the world. More than 60 languages. You can simply download the print, the soft copy. But if you want to buy a print copy, they charge very nominal, the processing charges of sending it by post to you, like that. But otherwise, this download is free of cost. And if you want to go into the online, you can read all this table of content. And here you can see it may be reproduced for non-commercial purpose. Just don't print it and sell it on the market of 100 rupees. Otherwise, for your students, download it, print it, and give it to everyone. Terry Anderson, Athabasca University Press, don't have any objection of that. There are these further books, Mobile Learning, Learning in Virtual Worlds, Emergence on Innovation in Digital Learning. wonderful book and free, officially allowed you to use it. Even you can take one chapter and you can edit that chapter and use it for you. The Emerging Technology by George Wallestinios. So that way, this is the book. You can use it for your purpose. The another one is OpenStax. I'm showing you from where you can download the textbooks. So here you can see the subjects: mathematics, science, social science, humanities, business essentials, high school, college level, university level. What? Say I want to search something for, you can see here, these are peer-reviewed books, openly licensed, 100% free. They won't ask you, and they are simple to adopt and free to use. Simply just get it. Say, for example, here is a book on history. And here is the table of content, and you can download a free copy. You can just make use of in going into their search engine, and from there you can locate what is good for you. There is another project. It is called as Open Textbook Project of Hong Kong. Here is the open textbook. So see, this is primary school, secondary school, certificate diploma level, or university textbooks. And they have very good books. You can just download that book as such. Say like communication theory. If someone of you is teaching communication theory, you can use it. Literacy, literature, and see here is the, you are allowed. Oh, so I said, say for example, business, accountancy. This is free open textbook for tertiary level. Feel free to use, adopt. Even you can modify the content to your own needs and share the content with others, because the book was offered under Creative Commons license. You simply download the PDF, or even if you want to go online, you can see the online book from here and tell your student that this is the online resource. If you want, you can read it. So the book will be opening here now shortly in front of you, and you can read it online. You can read it on your mobile phone, and like that you can go completely free. No copyright issue. Don't do plagiarism. Don't, there is no need for cheating anyone. And like that, it offers you a fantastic resource. Okay. So I think I have told you a good number of resources. I will stop here for a few minutes so that I can see the questions, or if there are something, and then you can ask me. Let me little bit scroll up. Okay, Bedjit Singh, may I request you to record? Yes, the lesson, the session is being recorded. Okay. How to change my name? I think you have done it already. Okay. Please, something of coronavirus. What about Wikipedia? I already replied to that. Okay. Any questions so far?